a tutorial, if you will, with you folks. I hope you guys are ready for all that. Not to mention, I'm going to be talking about what to look for, how to deal with things, and maybe how to progress based on a tribe colony. You know, I've been constantly always replaying a new game, mainly to show you guys what you can do and you know, different tribe members, essentially. I mean, we can do regular Rimworld, tribe, or solo man. So I'm down for either, all three, because we're going to be doing tutorials based on all three. And we're going to be trying to do tutorials based also on environments as well. So if you know biome, what to look for. If you choose a temperate biome where you know plants grow year-round, what are your priorities? What are you going to be looking for? Things like, you know, what animals do you want? What animals need? And, you know, how should you progress? What's important? Things like that. All right, folks? So, without further ado, let's get right into it. I was just about to say, let's get right into the news, but that's not me. That is not my thing. Okay. Get our Rimworld on. Game Mom's got some kind of, she's got these egg rolls going. Like sriracha egg rolls or barbecue. Sriracha barbecue? Sound good. Also, to give you folks a heads up, I'll be making a video about Ludian tomorrow. Well, and that they are not selling Steam keys on any platform, so except for Steam. So if you see Rimworld Steam keys show up on G2A, Kinguin, or anywhere else, please buy responsibly. They may be stolen. All right, folks, so be careful. Now, here's some staggering numbers. Since the 15th of July, Ludian has been able to sell over something like 60,000 copies of Rimworld. Yes, it's extremely popular. So, GG, my friends. G freaking GGGG.
GG!
Not to mention, you know, systems are like, it's kind of a big deal because when you charge back a game, that actually forces the devs to pay that price. It can be very, very painful. Especially if your game doesn't take off, that can completely kill an industry. Yeah, scary. All right, let's go. New colony, here we go. Start of this. We're gonna go with, wanna start with three people, 800 silver, packet three, 30 survival meat, 24 medicine, 30 components, a survival rifle, pistol, and plasteel knife, one random pet, 450 steel and 300 wood. This is the way the game was meant to be played. Map is scattered with ship chunk and steel. Package survival meat. Time 7. Rich explorer. I call this the solo rich man. Essentially, you know, one person. You already start with gun turrets research so you can defend yourself. And you have 2,000 silver, 30 gold, that's a lot of money. Package survival meat, 40 glitter world medicine, 30 components, a charge rifle, one random pet, 450 steel, 300 wood. That's a lot. That's a lot of stuff. And then you have Lost Tribe. Start out with 5 people. 200 silver. If you notice, no tech. 220 pemmican. That's like jerky. 12 herbal medicine. A wooden spear. A wooden club. A jade knife. 2 short bows. A pilla, which is kind of like a pike. And 3 random pets plus 500 wood. This is actually a really good start. You rush growing farms with this build. If you're playing in a winter biome, you hunt everything on the map. Solo rich man, you also have the ability to rush farm. But I mean, you have 40 packaged survival meat. You're all right here. And you have a ton of medicine. Like, you're going to be all right for a long, long time. You just set up a prison, set up a medical ward, and you set up, obviously, rooms with this build here, with the Rich Explorer. Crash landed. This is the way the game was meant to be played. But since we've been playing Lost Tribe and the Rich Explorer so much, let's actually do our first tutorial through Crash Landed. So we're not starting out with a whole lot of stuff, but this is the original game. We want to go... I like Randy Random. I like playing on rough because this can throw off all sorts of tutorials, guys. But I don't care. This is where the fun is, in my opinion. Randy Random. You never know what you're going to get. You're going to get hit with a blight right on your first set of crops. You might die. Randy Random might send in an all bionic raid of fully mechanite warriors. Well, that base went down real quick. Sucks to be you. It's a rare thing for it to happen right off in the very beginning. But I mean, it's not that bad. Let's go. Let's play. I'll use the general map. We're going to start with a year-round tutorial guide. There we go. Round growing. I'll take it. 50 and 83. That's insane. Obviously, you want the biggest map possible, or else it just feels too small. But this is how I play. I play on the absolute biggest map possible. This is how the tutorials are going to be played out. Smaller maps are going to be smaller than this one. Or you could play on half the size of this map. Go. Alright, let's see. Our three starting from the right. We got Black Servant, Wally Taxonomist, Dobie Botanist. You're psychically dull, you're lazy and abrasive. You're incapable of intellectual. You have crypto sleep sickness, which that affects your consciousness manipulation. You literally just I'm sorry, what? What? That's literally what your guy's doing. He's just like keeling over. I'm gonna randomize to try and get a better one. Bite scars? Whoa, she's 43. She got herself some bite scars on her neck and torso. She's been playing rough. Just saying. Too smart, hard worker, psychically dull. Incapable of dumb labor or scary. I don't know. Joy wire artist? Evelyn worked in an herb world lab developing cutting edge joy wire software to maximize user pleasure. The local government imposed harsh restrictions on joy wire manufacturing, began selling her products on the black market.
Woo!
Criminal surgeon. What? Pickpocket. Whoa! May have negatives, but I mean, we're not completely out. Sanguine, she's pretty happy, she's abrasive, and a night out. Plus, she's 39. You know what? I'm gonna roll with it. No, crypto sleeper, not. You know, this is a good person to have back at the base. Doing things. And a decent doctor. Guy. 27. That's 79. 23. Can I get someone who doesn't have crypto sleep? Or, like, bad stuff? Brawler, psychically dull, gay. Not bad. Incapable of intellectual. Researching is disabled, but this dude is a melee warrior. Into the melee! You're gonna be our farmer, straight up. Farming. Biosphere manager? Cult child? Man. You have, like, all sorts of bad things. Ugly and pessimist. Gonna run this for a minute. You suck. You couldn't do nothing. You're 25. You're relatively decent all over the board. You're jealous and lazy, though. Capable of dumb labor. Yeah, you can't, like, haul. You can't do none of that. Yep. Now this dude, 19, is straight up like one hell of a way to go, man. Let's do this. We got it. We got it. Go. All right, so what I'm going to show you guys when we start this map is how to set your priorities. People's priorities are probably going to be one of your most important tools. You're going to set up what their first objective is. Once they're done with that minuscule objective, you're setting up the next important one. So, like, if one dude's constantly cleaning, or like all three of them are cleaning, they'll clean all over the base and then immediately go into growing or whatever they're doing. But they'll keep the place as clean as possible. That kind of a thing. Here we go. We're crash landing. Barely make it. Here we go. Let's look at the map. See where we are. Wow, we're right here. Right here, man. This can work. Okay. Side. We're not doing too bad. We got a lot of bears on here. I already found two. Got some boomalopes all over the place. Some boomalopes. Some. Nothing too crazy. Nothing outrageous. Just wild stuff here and there. Alright, so I think I'm going to set up my base right in here. And have dudes dig. Way in here. But I'll set my farm up. We're gonna go right here. Close that off. This off right here. Now, close it off right here. Here. Then, like, right here. Fine by me. Let's do that. structures, a wood. Alright, I just set up, like, my area, usually all the time, like, where they're going to be, that kind of a stuff. Undoing all that sandstone wall architecture, like this. So we got the walls set up where we want, but so like this architecture, furniture, bed, three of us, bed. Structure. Go. Furniture. Air. Go. We set up this. And we got a prison, got a medical ward, or prison, medical ward, solo. Saying, you know, gotta keep the bases covered. Then we go zone, dump pile. Like this. By 25 zone storage, just chunks, rocks, and slag. fine. Area for rooting. Oh. Setting that up right there just because we have to. Now let's double click, get all our stuff set. Alright, who's our good shot? I was missing some. Here we go. 3, 0, 11. We're gonna give this. We're gonna get pistol. We're going to get. Let's go this route right here. Architecture, structure, wall. That. Door there, production, wooden butcher's table. Nope. That. Run it. Nope. Okay. Get back in here. We need the butchering table, the electric stove, and let's power. We want a fueled source. We want a fuel. There. Okay. Eh. What the hell? There's three of them. And, yeah, so go get them to it, right? Yeah, architect stockpile. Bridge. After all, we're going to allow medicine. It right here. So structure. Right. This area stockpile everything here. See, we're gonna put everything minus food and medicine. Weapons we're going to put on the inside here. Storage. All. Weapons. You want to keep your weapons near your folks, and we haven't even really started much. Set up our grow zones as well. Okay. potatoes, ice, corn. The hay grass. Do I want to go strawberry plants? Yes. Go hay grass right here? Definitely. We will go hay grass. All right, and now rush, my people, rush. Also, training our little doggy. We want to train him everything. Now let's look at these priorities here. These light boxes are good in hills. Let's click it over to manual because these are great and all, but everyone's got an equal priority to do those jobs. Setting it to manual means everyone's like, oh, that's my third job of choice. Obviously, if anything happens, we got fire. Everyone needs to be a patient. Two doctors. Everyone deserves to have bed rest. And, well, we don't need flickers yet. We're going to make you our wardens. You're both even. Meaning that job will take precedence. Chuki, Oaf, you're going to be our handler. And you're going to be our grower. So are you, though, Tony. You're at a 3. You're at a 1. Yeah, so Tony, we made the best choice there. You're going to clean. And everyone's going to be... be a handler once growing is done. Growing is just as important as constructing. Alright, we'll have plant cutters. Orders. Alright, go at work. We don't need miners just yet. Just yet. There we go, and off we go. Set up our roof zones as well. Gonna have to go structure. Go. And look at Chuki dropping the farm over there. He is planting like crazy. Get them walls built, my friend. Get them walls. Jin is doing a great job. Chuki is planting his butt off. And essentially, we're going to get this little base set up right away. So... Also, for joy, hurry up and make a horse there. Hurry up and make a wooden chest table. Only have 2 out of 3 beds made. Not a big deal, but at the same time, it's like, you know. Look at that. Shin is just destroying on the home front right now. He is crushing it. Well, that medicine here. There we go. So cancel for now. We're just gonna have the one general. We'll put up 2 more as needed. Guy is almost done here. We're gonna let him do his thing. He's doing all right. He's doing one heck of a fantastic job. What up, folks? What up? Yeah, he's doing a very fantastic job here. But this is how you get a quick base. Ken is doing both those jobs. He's going to plant cut, construct and repair, and warden when necessary. Area expand roof. Doing okay. We're almost done with this base here. And then I hope they rush this stuff. God, I hope they rush it. Again, come on, dude. Doing. Go. There we go. Yo, Soul Stalker, what's up? We're essentially doing a tutorial base right now. Hills. Oh, I did an electric stove. Damn it. Trevor, find me. Trevor, you want to set those to forever. So whoever's your cook is actually going to be cooking like crazy. However, we don't have power to it, so let's try and run that. quarters. Let's mine this out right here. My. So, we failed the bed construction, but that's okay. Okay, walls. All right, now here's what happens. Cargo pods fall from the sky, or you have random events where traders come in, you have raiders, you have problems, things that do happen. You're like, oh my god, how am I gonna deal with it? This is what you do. So we've detected a cluster of cargo pods. Let's get over there. We'll call our place Pine View for now. And you're like, oh, okay, cool. We've got some stuff. We've got some slag, and we've got 253 potatoes. Okay, that's not far from us. It's actually right up here, south of us. Tony, all that. We should pick up all of it. All three of us. Tony, Chuki, Chin. So we're essentially doing this. We're trying to do it right by you guys. This is the original RimWorld as it's meant to be played. We have rare Thrumbos in our location. These are one hell of an animal. They have some serious carry weight, all sorts of craziness. But my goodness, are they dangerous? They can be extremely deadly. All that wall out. I can make nice flooring. Your room matters, folks. What your base looks like matters. Because you have this thing here called, like, neutral, stress, content, stuff like that. That's scary. When it gets into stress, people can freak out, lose their mind, and essentially attack the colony. So you're kind of freaking out about that. And you want to keep that good mental state. Almost like, what's the one game? Darkest Dungeon. Almost like that. You want to keep a nice, healthy mental state. See, how's the animal doing? It lacks. Who's our handler, though? I'm going to make him a 1. Why? The handler's not constantly training the animal, but still. Alright, so Thrumbos are going to sit where the gardens are. Came all the way up to see us. Trying to tame him right now is a very bad idea. You kind of want to wait until you're like 16 to 20 taming level or handling level, where you're really, really good. See, how much limestone we got. All right, let's see. Or tile. Cargo pods. All right, let's jump to location. Flag. Chicken eggs, unfertilized. Dookie, come down here and get them. Tony, you come down here, get these. You have to be careful of bears and foxes, any meat-eating animal on the map, because they will attack your colony troops. They will attack them. And it's very, very scary. Build that roof. Deconstructing that marble wall there. Wow, look at these guys just going to town. Okay. Sweet. More cargo pods. All. Different. What are they? Oh. No. Double click on your people to immediately go to right, teleport to right where they are on the map. Got wolves in our area. Get them walls up, my friend. Wow. Wow! Throwing it down, man. Look at this guy. Wow! He is slapping it down over here. We have a little ways to go, but still. I always like walling off a decent area. That way I can keep my farmland and dump zones intact. And then I can go, okay, important stuff here, non-important stuff everywhere else. That kind of a thing. Architecture. Mm-hmm. to it up like this. Start putting that floor down. Started a colony, didn't realize it was still a year in. Oh my goodness. Alright, here's an instance. We have a mad animal. We gotta see where this thing's at. It's an alpaca. It's a manhunter. Check it out. Look, play it in slow. It's literally gonna come over here to the base, set up shop against us. It's gonna come after us. So, time being, all need to go on the offensive here. Actually attack this alpaca. Health, let's see. Ew. So pause. I forgot to set up the butchering bill on our table. Set it up for forever and have Tony prioritize butchering at wooden table right now. Not to mention you want to treat both ASAP. Look at that. Bruises and cracks. There we go. Getting healed up ASAP. I mean, this is not bad, folks. This is not bad. We have an eclipse going right now. It's like, meh. Eclipse. Eclipse. Architecture. Zone. Pro. Go forest. Kind of tree. Poplar. Set up this huge place. Okay. This guy's cool. If you can get a Megatherium, kind of a big deal. I mean, they have a 300 carrying capacity. They're outrageous tanks. They will destroy all sorts of good stuff. I mean, look at that. 9.2 DPS, average damage per second. Per second in melee combat. So, I mean, 98%. That's not bad. Wildness, 97%. See how our little doggy's doing. Where'd our dog go? Where is our dog? Mall. I don't know where he went. He's off doing something, man. Alright, now when you're playing regular Rimworld, you're going to come across these ship chunks. Deconstruct them. A chunk of spacecraft can be constructed to yield useful steel and components. Want those. Want those as much as humanly possible. Lewis, we're going to come up here and deconstruct them for the steel and components. Still a component. That's not bad. All of that, please. There we go. All them components, brother. All that. So architecture, temperature. Okay. This, setting up that right away. We have a mad animal, but it's at night, so it's not like it really matters. And because we have this right here right away, want to kind of jump into this ASAP. Might come across an instance where you might find a hive or a bug hive or cryopod, something. Oh my god, I got lucky. Okay. We won't come back here till later. Architecture. I'm gonna put a wooden door down. And we're gonna put a regular wall all the way across with a doorway, because this is going to be a nice little prison here. Limestone, stone, something. What is Shin doing? Been berries. And he's cloud watching. Why are you cloud watching? Work on that roof. We're gonna leave this here, and we're gonna set up turrets right outside this. So go all put a limestone block here, and pause danger. Area revealed. Cargo pods. Wow, 29? I'll take them components. 29 components. Woo! So we're deconstructing all this wall. See, I'm looking around for more wall. Specific wall. Something up right here. That'd be kind of cool. Like some kind of outpost. In. Alright, now let me come over here and deconstruct this. Hopefully, this is a bigger find. Hopefully, it has a hive in it so I can show you guys what I'm talking about when it comes to aliens and mecha droids and stuff like that. Please let it have a hive in it that we have to destroy. And nothing. Okay. Put a wooden door there, too. That's going to be a nice little spot, man. Acted plasteel. Take it, man. I'll take it. Still looking. Prioritize that. All the way out here, Shin. Can't see in here yet. Okay. Another work in progress there. Where I didn't get what I was looking for. Especially with this being on Randy Random and Rough. Yeah. Alright, now I'm checking down south. Not on my body, obviously. Up. Nope. That one there. And that there. Lots of compacted compacted machinery, though. This stuff right here. This weird color, that's compacted machinery in case you ever need compound parts. Stuff like that. Uh-oh, Shin's stressed. Tony's not. Dookie's not. Tony, please refuel that. Prioritize cooking on that stove, please. Work on that cooler. It's actually important that we get that cooler done so none of this food spoils in like 8 days. Instead, we can make this room frigid cold. Build that roof. Pause. Area revealed. Area. How about way down here? Area revealed. Oh, eight. Deconstructing steel wall. Okay. Well, tiles too. I want all of that. That's kind of a big deal. That's a huge find. Okay. Proof. Oh no, and as we see here, Chin's had a mental breakdown. He is wandering right now. Having a breakdown. Build that roof area. The roof area. Why is it that it's taking this long to build the roof area? All that rice. All them potatoes. Oh. An inventor named Adam Vax Covert calls you from nearby. He's being chased by pirates from Lion's Ridge. He begs for safety, offers to join your colony. Biologically, he's 26 years old. Be warned, if you accept, you'll have to fight off the pirates on his tail. So here's the situation, folks. This is what happens when you have the opportunity to bring someone into the crew, but at the same cost, you have to fight off their attackers. I'm going to accept. I'm going to offer safety. We need more people. At least 5 to make this go a little smoother. We have how many people chasing them? 2. Great. And what do they got here? Sniper rifle. Poor. Sniper rifle. Poor. Really? Wow. Why do I have to come across those guys? Character. You're really, really good at shooting. Holy cow. You're a careful shot, too. Jin, the surgeon, is hiding in his room. Oh, man. Hiding in his room, that ain't good. He is stressed the hell out. Go. Area reveal. Craft, animal, pirates. Wow. So, I'm running into an issue that I forgot all about. I forgot to make graves. Okay. I forgot all about making graves. Fire at tail. No, melee attack tail. What am I doing? Alright, we're all good to go. Draft. Undraft. Undraft. However, Tony. Rip him. Take that and that. Vax. Vax. I'm going to capture tail. Okay, let's go. All that. Tony. Party has finished. I didn't even know we had a party. Very steep. Vex? All? Ready yet? Forswear that. Scotty thing. That. All. Red. And whip a poor sniper right. Disease. Okay. Let's talk about diseases for a moment. Okay? We have heat stroke going on right now. Like initial heat stroke. And refuel that. Health. Fine, you're fine. Fine. Vex? Why aren't you dead, dude? Why are you not in a bed? Alright, you'll notice that people have positive and negative effects on their character. This affects their mood, and also affects the possibility of them going into a mental break, which could be very harmful to a new starting colony. You want to keep their joy up as much as possible, so I definitely condone the cleaning as much as possible. putting down wood flooring as fast as possible. You know, getting things done. Let's see what Vex is good for. I'm going to construct, repair. All. That's all I want him doing. He's done. He'll plant cut. All that other stuff. Oh, Shin's got a mental break. Oh, wait. No, Shin doesn't have a mental break. He's neutral. He's over here playing horseshoes. Started a colony today. Didn't realize you were on Phoebe until a year in. I mean, that's rough. That's rough. Super rough, man. Prioritize working on that. I don't know where the hell you were going. We need stuff done, though. We need stuff done. Work on that bed. There we go. What else is an okay shot? Let's look at our characters again. Got a pistol. She did great. She's like, bam, 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 bam. Really cool to see. How's her health? Ooh, she's got a bruised right fist. Bruised fist, man. How's our doggy? Alright, we're gonna create a spot for our animal. Build that roof, man. Build, 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 build. Work on that wall. All them blueberries, man. Berries, man. Dumped a mad animal. Oh no, it's a warg. Tony? Alright, here we go with the warg. Craft. Pack. Warg. Oh no, we have two of them. He is done, man. Craft. No way, man. And this is how you lose right away. Not kidding. Melee attack. And that's it, folks. We are done. We are done here. We can't even survive. Wow, my people are all down. We are dead. Chuki died first. Stressed out. She's bleeding out. Bleeding out. Jin's over there. He's watching her. She's watching it. You know, they can't do anything. They're crawling. They're like, oh, we can't go anywhere. No. This is it. They're, you know, they're yelling across the grass, you know, telling each other sweet, sweet goodbyes before they pass on. Meanwhile, Vax is surrounded by food. And he's, you know, he's messed up too. And he's going to become food fodder. We do have a chance of getting a recruit, but it's really, really rare. Look at our doggy. He's messed up, too. He is going to die because of treatment. All because them wargs didn't want to leave us alone. Those wargs. Man, this ain't even good. We had a bear here. But yes, this concludes the tutorial for the time being. I mean, it's not that big a deal, but holy cow, folks. Holy cow. There's a lot more here. If you guys feel that we did not answer enough stuff, feel free to leave comments and questions below. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Again, we are making this video as a tutorial to new players. New players, folks. So I hope you guys understand that. Yeah, it's game over, man. Game over! You know? But yeah, it is over. Look at that. Oh, we've had three people go down. Oh, wait, no. Maui got sick. Sucks to be Maui. But yes, folks. Oh, Jin has collapsed. Everyone is dying and getting diseased. And well, our one captor inside the base is kind of just chilling. Hale? What his needs? Ugly environment, extremely low expectations, but he's feeling good. He's kind of off on his own. He's got this whole place to himself. If he escapes, he's got this whole place to himself. But yes, folks, you can just let the game continue after everyone dies until a wanderer joins. And that's very, very rare. Let me explain that. It is extremely rare for a random person to show up and take over the base. So I've always started a new match because of that. All right, folks, so this is the end of the first tutorial video. And have a good one. Till next time.